Well, a very good evening. This is Derek Disley welcoming you once again to Hilton Park Lee for this evening's Stonesbitter Championship second division fixture between Lee and Fulham. The Lee lineup for this evening is at 1 Paul Topping, 2 Barry Ledger, 3 David Hill, 4 Ian Jeffrey, 5 Mick Round, 6 David Cruikshank, 7 Andy Sullivan, 8 Mark Shields, 9 Russ Bridge, 10 Paul Gamble, 11 Andy Collier, 12 Ian Potter, and 13 the skipper Peter Aparte. The Lee substitutes are at 14 Aaron Sawyer and 15 Terry Mellor. Visitors from Fulham, the Londoners, will line up as follows: 1 Greg Pearce, 2 Tim Luke, 3 Mick Taylor, 4 Brett Wilkins, 5 Roy Leslie, 6 Andy Stevens, 7 Craig Grove, 8 Mark Lee, 9 Dave Rotherham, 10 Noel Keating, 11 Peter Reinsfield, 12 Doug Winbourne, and 13 Russell Browning. And the two Fulham substitutes are at 14 Lachlan Churchill and 15 Richard Scarlett. Our match official tonight is David Campbell from St Helens, and our two touch judges are Mrs M Smith and J Fallon. So Lee, 9 games remaining in this second division campaign. Promotion not as yet out of the question. In fact, victory tonight could see them move into the top three. But Pearce gets the game underway for Fulham. Lee in possession inside their own 25. Lee, of course, had a narrow squeak 3 days ago, just beating Gunslet by 7 points, to being behind twice. Tonight, they're looking for consolidation at the top before the big crunch with Swinton on Sunday. So, knock on against Lee at the play of the ball, and we'll have our first scrum of the game just outside the home 25, which Craig Grove will feed. Grove feeds, possession to the visitors, standoff Stevens, marked by former Fulham player David Cruikshank, wearing the number 6 for Lee, and also a former Fulham player in Russ Bridge, wearing the number 9 jersey for Lee this evening. So it's Rotherham behind the play of the ball now for Fulham. Fulham looking to use their big forwards, almost up to the home 25. Grove now moving the ball out wide. A fine break by Pearce. Well caught from behind though by Hill. The fullback certainly threatened the Lee defence on that occasion. Grove again gets it out to second row Reinsfield. Still going, the ball lost. Referee will call them back for the knock on and will scrum it 15 yards from the Lee try line. So a bright opening by the visitors from London. Andy Sullivan to feed the scrum for Lee. Sullivan, of course, been filling in at loose forward in recent weeks. Lee come up with possession. And it's Rossbridge attacking halfback. So Fulham up very quickly. Bridge moves it left to Potter. Potter stops short of the 25. Bridge goes to Topping for the kick. There is a fine kick beyond Pearce. Makes him turn and chase to his own 25. For a fine response. And it took an ample tap from David Cruikshank to bring him down. So Leslie moves it inside to Grove, on to Stevens. Taylor tries to crash through centre field. Rotherham now moves it out to Browning. Grove once more dictating play in centre field for the visitors. Peter Aparte making the stop along with Sullivan. Well, Dave Rotherham behind the play of the ball. Short ball, well read by Shields as he brings down Browning. Last one indicates the referee. Kick comes in, bounces over the head of Barry Ledger. And we'll scrum it just outside the home 25 once more. It'll be head and ball to Lee. So Sullivan to feed once more. The free not happy with the first feed. And Sullivan feeds. Lee come up with possession again. Cruikshank, the fine break. Down centre field, good run. Ball Topping was the man making the break. Cruikshank now gets it out to Sullivan. Lee with a good line out. Rapati out to Jeffrey. Good defence though from Luke. He's certainly prepared to throw the ball about this evening. Topping again, breaking down centre field.
Come on, move it, lead him, oh bloody man.
Bridge now. Line charge from Shields. Bridge moves it left now. Sullivan onto Cruikshank. Short ball to Collier. Brilliant break by the second row. Stop 15 yards out. Last tackle indicates the referee. And what has the referee given? He's penalised Lee. He's called him back for the scrum. Well, no, in fact, he's penalised Lee for not playing the ball correctly and given a turnover the way of Fulham. So Fulham now with a good line out to their left. They're prepared to use the forwards inside their own 25. So Fulham, just outside their own 25, Rotherham behind the play of the ball. Down the short side once more. Rotherham goes from acting halfback, gets away to Browning. He's wrapped up though by Bridge and Hill. Browning again, out to Grouf, on to Stevens. The free calls them back for crossing, and Lee will get their first penalty of the game. In fact, the referee has not given them a penalty. He has in fact given a scrum down, which baffles me a little and the Lee supporters around me. But Lee come up with the ball anyway. Cruikshank can't get away from Stevens. Sullivan now. Lee keep the ball moving. Lee with a good line out here. Cruikshank goes back inside. So Lee trying to use their forwards to unlock this Fulham defence at the moment in these early stages. Cruikshank now against his former teammate. Doesn't get a good ball out, but a good break by Jeffrey. Jeffrey sidesteps inside two players, takes it back into the Fulham 25. Good attacking position for Lee. Cruikshank once more. Sit back inside amongst the forwards. Lee had a good overlap on this side. Last tackle this time. Cruikshank again. But it's dropped by Sullivan. And second turnover of the game in favour of the visitors. So here come Fulham now with Pearce. Good tackle by Collier. The ball is lost. Good tackle coming in from David Hill. Fulham lost 10 yards on that move. Browning now behind the play of the ball. Goes from acting half-back, clears the 25. Collier and Cruikshank make the tackle. Leslie now. Wingman trying to get in on the action. Rotherham looking for the kick. Grouf puts in the kick. Down centre field, should be an easy one for Topping to take. Runs onto that one quite well. Gets the ball out. Sullivan moves it across to Jeffrey. Jeffrey tries to sidestep them, half through. Takes play 10 yards into the Fulham half. Bridge now to Cruikshank. Lee stopped again by good Fulham defence, but get a penalty. First penalty of the game goes the way of the home side. He's taken 8 minutes for either side to get a penalty. And the touch kick takes Lee up to the 25. The first man in is Gamble. Sullivan. The ball is lost though, it's a break on for Fulham. Good defence, half defence anyway by Hill, but the pass is out to the second row of Wimborne. Lee fullback Paul Toppin is called out. I think the penalty will go Fulham's way. Fulham have grabbed an extra 10 yards, moving the ball forward 10 yards. Referee Campbell calls them back to the mark, and Greg Pearce will take the kick for touch.
What a lot of rubbish, man.
So Pearce drives Lee back to their own 25. And Rotherham now. First man in is Lee. Good break by Lee, gets a good ball back to Rotherham, but he loses it. Ledger picks it up for Lee. Lee back in possession. Lee looking for a league double, of course, over Fulham this evening. And it looks as though it's going to be as close as it was at Fulham back in January. But a fine break now. Fire a party. Good tackle from Pearce. Lee now with a good line out. Cruikshank. Cruikshank stopped though in centre field. Sullivan stopped as well. Two good tattles there coming in from Wimborne. Cruikshank there, out to Collier. Jeffrey stopped. Last tattle indicates the referee. Kick comes in from Topping. It's a fine kick again behind Leslie. Finds touch 15 yards from the Fulham try line. As we were saying earlier, Fulham pushed Lee all the way last month, when Lee won by 23 points to 20 down at Crystal Palace. And another good victory by 36 points to 2 at Chorley just 3 days ago. And it looks as though they've come here to give Lee a game this evening as well. So it's Grouf with the feed. Lee come up with possession. Sullivan now. Out to Cruikshank.
Inside.
Good defence again from Fulham. Tailed up quickly amongst the Lee backs. Lee just losing their way a little at the moment. It's now with Cruikshank. A fine break by Bridge. Lee still 15 yards out. Sullivan to Potter. Back to Sullivan. It's intercepted by a Fulham player. I think it's centre Brett Wilkins. So Pearce now. They're looking to contain Fulham in their own 25 now. But a good charge from Rotherham. Clears the 25 before Rapata gets the tattle in. Grouf now behind the play, the ball. Brings it round to Lee. Short kick ahead from Grouf. Could be a testing one. It's kicked on all the way by Grouf. If he can take this ball, he must surely score, but no, he drops on the ball. 15 yards out. I think the referee has wiped the slate clean. Fulham have got plenty of players over on that far side. They make a bit of a mess of it, and Lee come up with possession. So a good chance lost by the Londoners. Grouf really unlocked the Lee defence with that chip kick. And Lee now got to force their way out of their own 25. Well, Potter on the break, but on the charge, but no breaking this Fulham defence down at the moment. Kick comes in from Topping. That's certainly not the best of kicks. Leslie takes it 35 yards out. And Fulham back in possession just outside the Lee 25 with Grouf onto Rotherham to Lee. Lee again breaks the first tattle.
Bloody poor tackling, man.
So Rotherham moves it onto Grouf. Great ball to Pierce. Pierce slips at the feet of Topping.
Never played it.
Grouf again. Great defence by Lee. Last ditch tattles there. But Grouf went the wrong way on that occasion. Last tattle coming up indicates referee Campbell. Well, could be a try in the corner for Pierce, I think. Kick went into the arms of Leslie. Ledger got the tattle in, but Fulham are up first on the score sheet. It comes in the 15th minute, and they now lead Lee by 4-0.
Get some tattling done.
So Greg Pierce, his fourth try of the season, which he will now attempt to convert himself. Gives the Londoners the start they wanted. 15 minutes of the game gone, and they lead at Hilton Park by 4-0. So Greg Pierce, it's first attempt of the evening. The supporter's not happy with the length of time he's taking, but the referee has stopped the clock. It's a fine attempt by Pierce, but it's just short, just underneath the crossbar. But Fulham have got the lead they wanted. They've got 16 minutes of the first half of the Stones Bitter Championship second division fixture here at Hilton Park, as a scoreline of Lee 0, Fulham 4.
Get yourself bloody organised!
So Topping with the restart, which fails to go 10 yards. And the penalty goes Fulham's way. Well, Lee seem to have been rattled by that Fulham try. What can Fulham do now? Certainly prepared to take the game to their opponents. Browning is first man in. Northrum behind the play the ball. Brings in Reinsfield. Bridge makes the tattle. On to Lee. This time a first time tattle from Potter brings him down. Rotherham again. Grouf moves it out to Stevens. On to Pierce. Pierce gets away from Cruikshanks' attempted tattle.
Never played.
Grouf once more. Good line out on the far side, Fulham. But Lee stopped the move and it's the last tattle. Kick goes straight into the arms of Mick Round. In fact, his bigger partner is Ian Jeffrey. But now Lee with a good line out here. Cruikshank is it inside to Topping. Ball falls Bridge's way. Another bad pass. Finds Rapati. Rapati breaks clear up to halfway. Doesn't get the ball away in the tackle. Penalty against Fulham for offside, yeah, hence the ironical cheers from the home supporters. And Paul Topping will take the kick, asking what is to be given, and he's going to go for goal. Lee looking to get points on the score sheet, trail 4-0 at the moment.
Oh,
So ball topping, first attempt of the game. Almost 43 yards out, just to the left of the Fulham pulse. The kick doesn't even go dead. Pierce picks up the pieces for Fulham. Makes a fine break up to the 25 before he's stopped. And the visitors are back in possession. Rotherham now moves it left. A half break there. Good 10 yards gained by Mick Taylor, the centre. Now it's second row, Rhinesfield. Rotherham to Grouf. Stevens, well stopped in centre field. Grouf again, moves it out to winger Luke. What a fine break by Peter Aparte. He's stolen the ball in the tattle, and he's tattled a yard short. Lee get a penalty for lying on at the tattle, which was a bad decision really by the Fulham player, because Lee had no one up to take the ball if he'd have played it. So it's 10 minutes in the sin bin for Greg Pierce for the professional foul, and Lee will surely tap this. Electing to kick for touch to give themselves a bit more room to work with. Lee will now tap 10 yards out. And they've got the advantage of an extra man. So what can they do here? Cruikshank now. Lee with a big overlap on this side. Jeffrey steps inside. Good defence from Stevens. Good defence again by Fulham. Bridge now. Moves it left to Cruikshank. Long pass to Sullivan. Lee with the overlap. Terrible pass for Round to take. It's forced back inside. But almost a break from Round. Stopped just short of the 25. Potter now. Fulham's defence withstanding this Lee onslaught at the moment. Cruikshank. The ball is knocked down. I think Lee may get six more. The referee has waved it all on. Sullivan dodging and weaving. Lee got six more tackles, but Fulham again have shown their defensive qualities. Bridge now. Cruikshank drops it. Potter picks it up. Gets it away to Aparte. But Lee just want more time than Fulham will allow them. Lee get another penalty for hanging on at the tattle. So ball topping electing to go for touch on this occasion. Lee wanted to use the one man advantage they have at the moment. Fulham have not had possession since Pierce went off. So the position is there for Lee now, just 12 yards out. Can they work anything? Bridge on to Gamble. Two drives to set up the position. Bridge moves it out now to Sullivan, to Cruikshank. A terrible move by Lee. Well, that move was misread, and Fulham come up with possession. Lee on the charge. Rotherham goes from acting half-back.
Pass the bloody ball, that's all you have to do.
Now Grouf at acting half-back. Brings in the second rower, Rhinesfield. Peter Aparte down injured at the moment for Lee. Here comes Taylor, looking for space on the outside. Last tattle indicates the referee. Aparte limps back into the play. Grouf puts the kick in. Brown takes that one. Good tattle by Taylor though. And a penalty to Lee again. Lee a little fortunate there. There was no one behind the ball when the ball was played back by Round.
Bring your bloody head in up, will you?
Topping, finds touch once more. Lee just 25 yards out. 24 minutes gone. And what can Lee do on this occasion? They're just 12 yards out again. And Bridge now, the two drives have gone in. It's now to Sullivan to work the move. The party seem to be brought down rather heavily there. Bridge moves it left to Cruikshank. Cruikshank goes on his own. Well, Lee are over the try line, but on their back indicates referee Campbell. No try is given. Seems to be an injury to a Fulham player. And also a Lee player receiving treatment. So be head and ball to Fulham. Fulham, of course, still with 12 men. Greg Pearce in the sin bin. Lee attempt to push them off it. The ball goes out of play. Free calls them back for the scrum once more. And this time Lee have head and ball. Well, Sullivan wins it. Cruikshank. Sullivan, the move was well read again by Fulham. Cruikshank now. Potter, not the best of passes to Topping. Did well to take that one low down. Potter on to Shields. It's better from Shields, but good defence again from Fulham. Bridge now. Sullivan on to Rapati. To Hill. Hill forced inside. Good tattle by Grove. Now Lee within 10 yards. Good line out as well. Sullivan to Cruikshank. On to Collier. Again, Fulham have held them, and it's the last tattle coming up. So Cruikshank launches the eye up and under. Safely taken though by Leslie. Fulham will get the tap on the 25. Lee really needed points from all that pressure. Fulham, to their credit, have absorbed it well. Rotherham on the tap to Taylor. Now on to the number 10 Keating.
Down below. We won't go without
things. Rotherham to Lee.
Come on, Lee. Come on, you naughty thing.
Grove now. Good inside ball to second row Wimborne.
Move up, John.
And a good overlap here for Fulham. Keeping the ball moving, it's inside to wingman Luke, and they're still going. Superb rugby from Fulham. Ball lost at the end in the tattle, but Lee supporters respond to that open rugby from the visitors. So now we'll scrum it once more, this time inside the Lee 25. So the reshuffled Fulham lineup shows that Roy Leslie is occupying the fullback berth in the absence of Pearce. Browning has come out of the pack to go to standoff. Well, Lee win the scrum. Certainly wasn't the best of scrums we've seen in a rugby league match. McCarty tries his luck from acting half-back. Certainly Lee having trouble unlocking this Fulham defence. Forced a kick. Topping's great kick forces Roy Leslie to turn and chase. And Leslie takes the ball and then steps out of play. And Lee will get head and ball at the scrum. That was a bad mistake by deputy fullback Roy Leslie. Andy Collier limping now for Lee. So it'll be Sullivan to feed the scrum once more. Lee win that one. Into the line comes Topping. He gets the ball away to Sullivan. Long ball finds Jeffrey. Jeffrey sidesteps inside and out. Takes it up to the 25. Bridge moves it left now. Topping gets it out to Potter. Hill brings it back inside. Lee with a good overlap, but Sullivan straightens up. Bridge now on to Shields. Mark Shields, 10 yards short of those Fulham posts. Where's the break going to come from? Sullivan goes down centre field. Looking to release the ball in the tattle. No one near enough. A wild ball finds its way out to Cruikshank. On to Potter. Good charge from Potter. Potter stopped just 5 yards out. Last one indicates the referee. Up and under once more from Cruikshank. Dropped by Leslie. Lee will get six more. So Lee keep the pressure on. Rapati moves it now to Bridge. Bridge tries to straighten the mover. No way through again. Hill now. Cruikshank. Lee with a good overlap here. Shields tries to brush them off. Good defence in centre field. Lee still on the move though. Finds its way out to Round. Round's in touch though. He gets over the line, but he's forced out of play first. And this Fulham defence is really rising to the occasion here at Hilton Park this evening. Just 9 minutes of the first half remaining. Lee still trail by 4 points to nil to the visitors from London. So Fulham come up with possession from that scrum. And can Lee keep them here? They've got to get the pressure on. Greg Pearce looks as though he's ready to return from the sin bin. Fulham using their big forwards in centre field. Drive the ball clear. Taylor behind the play of the ball now. Clears the 25. Pearce is not on as yet. Rotherham moves it to Grouf. Last tattle coming up indicates referee Campbell. Kick comes in from Stevens.
Come on, Topping.
Paul Topping takes it 20 yards from his own try line. Makes 10 yards before he stopped. Potter now. And Fulham back to a full complement. Greg Pearce is back on the field now. Lee loosen up the substitute. I think it's Terry Miller. Bridge knocks on. And Lee looking to bring off Paul Gamble. In fact, it's Fulham that are bringing a substitution off. So Noel Keating goes off to be replaced by Richard Scarlett. And Lee want to make a substitution as well. It's Terry Miller. So Andy Collier limps off to be replaced by Terry Miller. Fulham win the scrum. Stevens loses Cruikshank. Great defence by Topping. Again, Lee with little to offer in centre field. Well, that looked like crossing, but Fulham get away with it. Rotherham behind the play of the ball. Lee's defence holds on this occasion. Fulham pressing hard here. They've had to withstand some good pressure from Lee. Now they're coming back at them. A 10-yard shot of that Lee try line. Rotherham behind the play of the ball. Out to... it's an easy walking try for Fulham. Second try of the evening. I think it's number 8, Mark Lee. And Lee with all sorts of problems once again. They now trail Fulham by 8-0. Well, Mark Lee is credited with the try, and this should be an easy conversion attempt for Greg Pearce, especially after the valiant attempt he made from his own try some 20 minutes ago. So Greg Pearce just to the left of the Lee pulse, and certainly it's a subdued Lee crowd at the moment. We've seen Lee have the greater territorial advantage in this opening 35 minutes, but they've now seen Fulham score 2 tries without reply. Pearce tags on the goal points. 4.5 minutes of the first half remaining. The scoreline now of Lee 0, Fulham 10. So it'll be Paul Topping with the restart from the centre. Fulham playing with total confidence now. Grove clears the 25 before he stopped. Once again, Fulham attacked. Rotherham attacked an halfback for Fulham. Lee really need points before the interval. It's Fulham in possession at the moment. That's better tattling from Lee. Rotherham now to Grove. On to Taylor. Last one indicates the referee. Grove puts in the kick. Forces Ledger to turn and chase. Takes it just inside his own 25. Stopped by Wilkins' tattle. And Lee back in possession on their own 25. Comes new boy Terry Miller. He only makes a couple of yards. Shields on the charge. Rapata now. But there's no way through centre field at the moment, the way these Fulham forwards are tattling. Bridge throws it back to Topping for the kick. Straight into the arms of Tim Luke. So Fulham back in possession on halfway. 2.5 minutes of this first half remaining. Fullback Pearce breaks through some paper-thin Lee defence, and he shrugs off 2 more would-be tattlers, takes it up to the Lee 25. And they've got all sorts of problems at the moment. Substitute Scarlett in on the move now. So Fulham using their good big forwards to good effect again. Rotherham gets a cute ball out. The lead defence holds, it's the last tackle. Here comes Lee again, inside, the ball is dropped. Good defence by Lee, forced the turnover. But it's points more than anything Lee wants at the moment. We get a penalty again for offside. And Lee tap it quickly. They don't catch the Fulham defence out. We move up to just 70 seconds remaining of this first half, and Lee have got to really conjure up something from somewhere. There's certainly looked no way through. Free calls them back for the knock-on. We'll scrum it on the home 25.
I thought they played bad on something.
So Grove to feed for Fulham. Free not happy with the first feed. And the penalty, I think, has gone. No, the referee has not given a penalty. They're doing a lot of whistling at the moment. And again, he's not happy with the scrum. The scrum's taken a full minute already. Now the fourth attempt, Lee come up with possession. So can Lee get anything before the interval? We've had the normal 40 minutes, just added time now. Bridge now moves it out to Cruikshank. Break by Rapatti, well covered though. Good tattle from Stevens. Cruikshank now. Sit out to substitute Mellot. Ball is lost. Fulham back in possession. And Fulham take the game back to Lee straight away. Rotherham now. Behind the play of the ball. On to Pearce again. This time Pearce is upended by Bridge. Leslie behind the play of the ball. He stopped on the 25. Rotherham now, Grove. Looking for the inside ball from Wimborne, which didn't come. Short kick ahead. Shepherded over the dead ball line by Topping, and Lee will tap from their own 25. We've already had 90 seconds of added time at the end of this first half. It's the Hooter goals to bring to an end a rather dull first 40 minutes as far as the home supporters are concerned. It's a half-time scoreline here at Hilton Park of Lee 0, Fulham 10. Well, welcome back to Hilton Park for the second half of this evening's Stones Bitter Championship second division fixture. Half-time scoreline. Half-time scoreline of Lee 0, Fulham 10. Our referee, David Campbell, gets the second half underway. And a second half substitution for Lee. Aaron Sawyer has come on to replace Andy Sullivan. And it's Fulham in possession, holding all the aces at the moment. His 10-point advantage. As Lee drives forward over his own 25. The other prop. I thought it was Keating, but he's supposedly gone off. Good play. Taylor again bursts out of her tackle. A fine break by winger Luke. Good defence by Topping. The ball still going. Dropped on by Cruikshank. But again, the Lee defence was found wanting. And they're a long time regrouping. Shields takes the ball up from acting half-back. Now it's Bridge behind the play of the ball for Lee. A lucky escape there for Lee. Moves it right to Potter. I think these Fulham forwards will tattle all night the way they played in the first 40 minutes. Miller goes without the ball. Chances lost. We'll have a scrum just 15 yards from the lead try line. Make of the tattle was Scarlett, who has not risen from the tattle. So nothing going Lee's way at the moment. As Richard Scarlett receives treatment. Looks as though there are from the reactions of scrum half Craig Grove that it could be a leg injury. Well, Fulham, of course, have never won here at Elton Park, but certainly that is on the cards for a change tonight, the way they've dominated the first 40 minutes. Substitute is fit to continue, and Fulham win the ball, but it's dropped by Grove, and Lee will get head and ball at the scrum now. So Sawyer feeds and wins the ball for Lee. Lee camped in their own 25 once more. Shepardy tries to take them on. Potter drives him. Fulham will stand this all night. Lee have got to vary the play somewhere. Shields now. He's only up to the 25 when he stopped. Kick will come in from Topping. It's behind Luke. He bounces kindly for him. Jeffrey gets to tattle him. So what can Fulham do from halfway? Pierce moves it out to Taylor. Rotherham gets the ball out, not the best of passes. Nice long ball. Fulham halfway through the gap. Ball finds its way out to Leslie. Certainly Fulham more adventurous with the ball in their hands than the home side so far in this game. And again they throw the ball about with Gay. Abandon, a fine break from Wilkins. He'd men inside, but a good tattle coming in from Topping. It's the last tattle. Grove onto Taylor. Ball's thrown inside. They take him over on his back. In fact, the referee indicates a knock-on, so Lee will no doubt get a tap from the 25. So Sawyer with the tap now for Lee. First man in is Potter. Bridge now, onto Rapati. Rapati makes 10 yards, but Lee are still to break down this Fulham defence. Well, Fulham have made a substitution that I didn't see. Churchill has come on for Scarlett. Lee in possession at the moment, trying to unlock this Fulham defence. Rich moves it left now to Sawyer. Sawyer tries to dummy. Fulham don't fall for it. Last tackle indicates the referee. Penalty goes Lee's way. Against number 10, Noel Keating, who we were told had gone off in the first half. So the kick comes in from Topping. The Lee supporters try to get behind their side. Going to score twice, of course, to win. Shields flattens the referee. been going Lee's way yet. Is the break going to come on these six tattles? Sawyer now to Cruikshank and to Rapati, but Fulham are reading all these. Lee moves well at the moment. Sawyer again to Cruikshank. Gets it inside. Break is on now from Bridge. Inside to Mellor. A half break from Lee takes them to within 15 yards of the Fulham try line. Again, the Fulham defence stands its ground. Sawyer now. Sawyer takes them on. Last one again indicates our referee, Mr. Campbell. Cruikshank launches the eye up and under. Fulham come up with possession and Lee can't force them over their own try line. So now Lee have got to try and force the error. Fulham settling for the one-man rugby to try and clear their lines. Comes the substitute, Churchill. They're up to the 25. It's the last tattle, though, indicates the referee. And they look for the kick from Pierce. Just run away from him. In the end, Sawyer covers the kick and Pierce makes the tattle. Shalee were caught ball watching on that occasion. Brown trying to go down centre. And again, there's no way past this Fulham six at the moment. Sawyer hands on. Cruikshank dummies back inside to Sawyer. Sawyer gets it inside onto Ledger. Lee beginning to find a bit more space to use the ball. Rapati now. It's a long ball out to Hill. Good defence though by Leslie. And the penalty goes Lee's way again. Well, I've had 9 minutes of this second half. Lee have had the far greater territorial advantage, but they still seek their first points of the evening. No ball at the moment. And Lee want to make another substitution. And I think Paul Gamble's going off to be replaced by Andy Collier. In fact, it's Sullivan that's coming back. So Lee now, Hill to Jeffrey. Jeffrey gets it away well to Round. Round to Hill. On to Cruikshank. Cruikshank dummies and weaves. Keeps it going for Sullivan now. It's out to Lee are in for the try. I'm not sure who the try scorer is, but that was a deserved try. That was a real team effort. David Hill is the try scorer on 10 minutes of the second half. Lee are on the board at last. They now trail Fulham by 10 points to 4. Come on! So Lee supporters at last, something to cheer.
I think that's both
wingers. Paul Topping now. The second attempt of the evening to try and reduce the deficit to just 4 points.
Now you've got the idea. Keep it bloody going. Good
So Paul Topping just 10 yards to the right of the Fulham post. Fails though. Yeah. 11 minutes of the second half gone. Lee back in it now. It's a scoreline here at Hilton Park of Lee 4 points, Fulham 10. So Greg Pearce with the restart. Potter makes that his own. So Lee back in possession. Will they be encouraged to better things by that try? Bridge now, terrible ball to Sawyer. And Rapati drops it as well. So Lee go back to their own 25. Bridge tries to take them on, can't get away from Wilkins. Sawyer tries to crash through centre field. Forced back though. Last tackle indicates the referee. Topping gets the kick in. Well taken again by Luke. Cruikshank with the tackle. Fulham back in possession on halfway. So Taylor now from acting halfback. Tackled by Rapati and Bridge. Pick number 11, Rinesfield, drives in. Rotherham. Good short ball inside. Fulham looking to work a move here. Rotherham moves it left to Grove. Grove dodges and weaves. Last tackle indicates the referee. High up and under from Grove. Lee get the penalty for Fulham being offside. Relief for the home side. Topping will take the relieving kick to touch. Lee will tap just a couple of yards short of their 25. Missman in his shields. Bridge now on to Mella. Three calls them back for the knock on. We'll scrum it over on the far side of the field. We head and ball to Fulham. Grove to feed. The free not happy with the first attempt once more. So possession to Fulham in the end. Ball lost though. Greg Pearce streaks away. Lee will have head and ball at the scrum this time. And the free indicating the ball went straight through the pack. And the penalty goes Lee's way before the scrum can be fed. So Paul Topping with the kick for touch. Finds touch on halfway. Bridge now. This one in his shields. Again, the referee was almost knocked down by shields. Mellor again, second man in. Sawyer now to Sullivan. They were waiting for Rapati. Sullivan to Sawyer. Fine dummy by Sawyer, good tattle though from Browning. Sawyer plays it to himself. No one went with him. Last tattle indicates the referee. Cruikshank with the chip kick. Well taken by a Fulham player. I think it's wingman Luke coming across to cover. And Lee have got to do the tattles all over again. Fulham again going down centre field. They've made good yardage with their forwards this evening. Rotherham now, and again a good charge. Wimborne going from acting half-back on that occasion. Fulham are inside the Lee half now. Grove dictating play still. Last tattle this one indicates the referee. Grove puts a fine grubber kick. Topping forced to play it. And gets tattled behind his own try line. And a total misread of the situation there by Paul Topping. And Lee will be forced to drop out from under their own posts. Well, 17 and a half minutes of this second half gone. Things not going Lee's way as yet. Churchill picks it up inside his own half, makes 20 yards before he's stopped by Sawyer and Cruikshank. Here comes winger Luke. He makes 15 yards, and Fulham running with grim determination at the moment. Gross short ball to Pierce. Ball's thrown away, but they come up with possession again, Fulham. Prepared to take chances. Gain the big forwards. Take them to within 10 yards of that Lee try line. Well, that certainly looked forward. This is the last tattle anyway, indicates the referee. The kick goes backwards. But Lee will get the advantage of the turnover. Potter now for Lee, but again the Fulham tattlers there in numbers, and they've got to move this ball wide. Jeffrey tries to break clear from acting half back. It's a good 10 yards, and it's Ledger behind the play of the ball, out to Sawyer, to Sullivan, onto Rapati. Your pardon, it's not Rapati. Fans not happy, wanting the side to move the ball. Sawyer dodging and weaving, gets a good pass out though. Last tattle. Well, it's thrown away in the end. And it falls Fulham's way for Mick Taylor. And Lee are really losing their way once again. And it's Luke on the charge. Rotherham behind the play of the ball. Again, Fulham make good yardage. Rotherham on to Grove. On to Stevens. The half break from Stevens. He hangs on to possession. Taylor behind the play of the ball for Fulham. He takes it into the Lee 25. Last tattle. Rotherham to Grove. Grove launches the eye up and under. Falls for a Fulham player, but Lee will get a second turnover in this period. The third of the match altogether. So Potter drives up to the 25. Shields on the charge. Topping now attacked in halfback. Out to Meller. It's pretty one-man rugby from Lee at the moment. Cruikshank. A half break from Cruikshank. Fine inside ball to Sawyer. Sawyer's going to take them on. So to Rapati. On to Mick Round. But Round is over. Mick Round back in the side. scores his 13th try of the season and gives Lee the opportunity to get back on level terms. That try comes in the 22nd minute of the second half and makes the scoreline Lee 8 points, Fulham 10. So a great break from David Cruikshank, who just over 7 days ago was a Fulham player. And it's Paul Topping now with the opportunity to tie things up at 10 points each.
Why is he going around running Carnival? He's liable to kick it on Carnival.
So Topping's third attempt of the evening is successful. 17 and a half minutes remain here at Elton Park. That brings the home supporters to life. It's a scoreline now of Lee 10 points, Fulham 10.
You've done it once, do it again.
So Greg Pearce back at the centre with the restart. Fulham have seen the 10 point interval lead whittled away. The kick goes deep. So a fine break by Ledger, looking to go all the way, stopped 10 yards short of halfway, and Lee supporters rising now, good line out here, Cruikshank onto Rapati, good tackling though from Taylor, Jeffrey onto Potter, Potter drives back in though, Browning with the stop for Fulham, Sawyer now. Onto Cruikshank, but he comes back in the middle of game. So Bridge going from acting half back, makes 10 yards, but it's the last tattle this time. Potter now, out to Sawyer. The ball is thrown away in desperation on the last tattle, and Fulham pick up the pieces. So Fulham with it all to do. Lee suddenly looked the better side. This game a long way from over with as Wimborne drives in. Rotherham now on to Greif, on to Stevens. Fulham in possession in centre field inside their own half. Great tattle that one on Wimborne. Last one indicates the referee. Kick will come in from Greif. Ledger forced to turn and chase. Picks it up 15 yards from his own line. It doesn't get away from the first tattler though. Stopped on the 25. So Lee with the forwards backed. Time to regroup now. Ledger behind the play of the ball. Sawyer forced to go it alone. Rapati now hands it on. Luke for the kick from Topping. Forces Tim Luke to turn and chase. Back to his own 25, and then he drops on. Drops the ball and knocks on. So as the tide turned, things suddenly beginning to go Lee's way. Yep, still got to score to win. Going to be Sawyer to feed the scrum. They come up with possession. Cruikshank, not the best of balls, gets it out to Topping. Sullivan now hands it on to Mellor.
This is where everyone's got now. You're all sick of bloody sands here.
Shields on the charge. Lee driving to try and set up this position. Now it's to Sullivan. A break on from Sullivan. The ball's thrown away. And a penalty kick goes Lee's way. And Lee will go for goal to try and go ahead for the first time in the game. And the kick's just outside the Fulham 25. Paul Topping's only got one this evening. So far, Lee supporters will be hoping he can make it two with this one. Just 13 minutes remain here at Hilton Park. Score is tied up at 10 points each. Well, Lee were involved in a cliffhanger with Hunslet just 3 days ago, and it looks as though this could go the same way this evening. So Paul Topping lines the kick up, 26 yards out, right in front of the Fulham post. Vital kick that could put Lee ahead for the first time in the game. Crowd tells us that it's there. Paul Topping's second goal of the evening, and Lee have turned a 10-point deficit at half-time round. They now lead by 12 points to 10 here at Hilton Park, and there's just 12 minutes remaining. Well, Lee will still want 6 points from somewhere to give themselves a cushion, because Fulham are by no means out of this one. And it's Lee back in possession on their own 25. Fulham again up quickly. Lee should have learned that the only way through this evening has been on the outside. Potter drives in. Gridge now attacking half-back. Kick from Topping. It's a fine kick again over the head of Pearson. Luke Pearce takes it and is stopped 10 yards short of halfway. So what have Fulham got left to offer? Taylor now out to Grove. Rotherham again behind the play of the ball. Puts Wimborne on a run. Lee stop him on halfway. Mick Taylor, centre, appears amongst the forwards. Grouf again. Half break. Ball comes inside, picked up for Lee. Rapati immediately runs straight at them. Good tackle by Browning. Sawyer stopped by Stevens. Sullivan moves it out now. Shields. Lee just not going anywhere at the moment. Bridge from acting halfback. Almost through. Stopped by Taylor, but it's the last tackle. Kick from Topping. Luke takes it at the second attempt inside his own 25. Lee beginning to get on top, pushing Fulham back gradually, but Fulham standing their ground at the moment. Pearce in the line, no way through for the fullback this time. Certainly Fulham not as organised as they were in the first half. I think the pace is beginning to get to them. Here comes that man Taylor again. He straightens the move up, takes it up to halfway. Grouf again. Last tackle indicates referee Campbell. Short kick ahead. Taken well by Topping. Topping on the counter. Good 30-yard rescue run by the Lee fullback. And And Aaron Sawyer is penalised for pulling the Fulham player off. Lee wanted to get on with the game. Paul Topping was being held down. Aaron Sawyer just dragged the Fulham player off and is penalised by referee David Campbell. And Greg Pearce, no doubt, will go for goal from this position. Side 2 points behind at the moment. And down, I think, is Mick Taylor, which will be a sad loss if he had to go off for Fulham. Then after a stretcher for Mick Taylor, but no one seems to be taking them on. And Mick Taylor will be forced to leave the field. That's a bad blow for the visitors. Taylor leaves the field and Greg Pearce will now go for goal to try and tie things up for Fulham. So Greg Pearce, one trying a goal to his credit so far this evening. Just under 7 minutes of normal time remaining. Difficult kick for him. 42 yards out. Taking all the time he wants, the Australian fullback. Kicks it well and gets it over. That silences the home supporters. Just 6.5 minutes remaining. Greg Pearce, his second goal of the evening, ties things up once again. It's now a scoreline of Lee 12 points, Fulham 12. So Lee restart again. Pearce takes behind his own line and is up to the 25. Suddenly Fulham find a few reserves to take the game back to Lee. Not ready to get to the other end. They'll be looking for a drop goal to clinch the points. Charge this time from Wimborne. Rotherham out to Grouf. Rotherham again. Half break down centre field, but last tackle indicates the referee. Kick comes in from Grouf. Ledger takes that one, but he's top 15 yards from his own try line. Lee have got to go a long way to pull this one out as the rain worsens here at Hilton Park. No way through for Bridge. Sullivan goes from acting halfback, clears the 25. Fulham to Luke, looking to contain Lee here. Kick comes in from Topping though. Luke takes it midway between his own try line and halfway. Jeffrey gets the tackle in, but Fulham are back in possession. Pearce now. Jeffrey makes the stop again for Lee. Rotherham moves it right this time. Rotherham again on to Grouf. Long pass finds its way out to Keating. Rotherham again out to Grouf. The ball's dropped. Lee come up with possession on halfway. So Lee have forced the error. Can they capitalise on it now? No, they lose their footing. Substitute Terry Miller. Cruikshank tries to go from acting half-back. Miller takes it on again. Lee supporters want them to move it wide. Shields drives down centre field as well, and it's the last tattle. So Topping now, forced to run it and makes the break as well. Kicks ahead. Is it going to be too strong? It is. The ball goes dead. And Fulham will be relieved to tap from their own 25. So Fulham, 10 yards outside their own 25. David Cruikshank has been nominated as Lee Man of the Match for this evening. It's only his second appearance for the club. Rotherham now. Fulham trying to use the short side. Looking to set up the position for the drop, but they've a lot of yardage to make yet. Up quickly on Grouch, but he gets away out of two tattles. But loses possession. Ledger comes up with it for Lee. Well, what can Lee do now? A break from Cruikshank. Gets it inside to Repartee. Can Lee find something in these remaining 2 minutes? Repartee now out to Sullivan. Out to Ledger.
No bloody moving back! Christ almighty, you need to be on the wheel!
Short kick ahead. Comes off the Fulham player, but Leslie recovers to pick up the ball.
If you don't kick to advantage, though.
It's now with fullback Pierce. Now Lee have got to force an error, just 90 seconds of normal time remaining. Scores tied up at 12 points each. Fulham using up the clock. Substitute Churchill driving in. Almost up to halfway. Again, Fulham use the big men. Last tattle indicates the referee. Kick comes in from Pierce. Picked up by Cruikshank though. Gets it out to Jeffrey. Jeffrey sidesteps inside. That certainly looked a high tattle. Touch judge indicates that it was. And Jeffrey lies prostrate on the ground. Lee have got the penalty. Difficult decision now for Lee. Does he go for goal? He is going for goal. Well, we've only got 20 seconds of normal time remaining here at Hilton Park. It's make or break now for Paul Topping. Well, difficult kick for Topping, 26 yards out, 10 yards in from this near touchline. We're moving to added time at the end of this match. So Paul Topping, two goals to his credit so far this evening. The crowd silences for him. So Paul Topping. He draws it wide and it doesn't go dead either. Fulham come up with possession. That could be Lee's last gambit. So Fulham in possession. Should be some amount of injury time in this second half. Fulham using the clock up. Last tattle indicates the referee. The The defence has done its job this time. Where will the kick go? He throws the ball away to Leslie, and Lee stop him 10 yards out, so Lee will get a turnover. Now what can Lee do from here? In fact, they get a penalty again. The Fulham lying on at the play of the ball and not giving the ball up. And this time Lee elect to run it. So they're just 10 yards out, deep into injury time. Lee have got a good line out to the left, but they go right. And again, it's one-man rugby. Supporters screaming for them to move it out. Cruikshank goes back in the middle as well. Well, all one-man rugby from Lee, unless they're setting up the position for the drop goal. So Lee move it out and Hill drops it. Lee make a mess of it in the end. Turnover goes Fulham's way. The chance is lost. That could be all over for Lee as they go offside as well. Three minutes of added time gone. Pierce puts the ball out just short of halfway. So Rotherham with the tap now. What can Fulham do? The hooter goes to bring to an end a very disappointing performance by Lee here this evening at Elton Park. So final scoreline in this evening's Stonesbitter Championship fixture of Lee 12 points, Fulham 12. For Lee, a try each from David Hill and Mick Round, with two goals from Paul Topping. For Fulham, a try each from Greg Pearce and Mark Lee, with two goals from Greg Pearce. So it's goodbye from a rather wet, dismal and disappointing Hilton Park, with a final reminder of this evening's scoreline. It's Lee 12 points, Fulham 12.